purple loosestrife is a perennial wetland weed. Native to Europe, Asia, and Northern Africa, purple loosestrife was introduced to North America in the 1800s as a contaminant in ship's ballast and animal wool. It was also intentionally brought to North America for ornamental and medicinal purposes. Purple loosestrife is still regularly used in horticulture and is readily available for purchase in some places. This weed has been reported throughout most of North America. Purple loosestrife invades natural and disturbed wetlands, such as stream banks, lake shores, marshes, wet meadows, drainage ditches, and irrigated pastures. Established plants can tolerate drier sites. Purple loosestrife displaces native plant species, harms waterfowl nesting habitat, has negative impacts on some amphibians and algal communities, reduces water flow and quality, and degrades hunting and fishing areas. Seedlings germinate in late spring or early summer and develop a strong, branching, eventually woody root system. Plants can grow over 3 feet tall in their first year and may even flower. In subsequent years, stems may grow up to 9 feet tall, though most are only 4 to 5. Multiple stems typically grow from one large root crown, and stems are often highly branched. Stems are squarish in cross-section and have 4 to 6 sides. They can be either smooth or covered with downy hairs. Leaves are 2 to 5 inches long and typically a half inch wide. Leaves are lance-shaped, smooth-margined, and have heart-shaped or rounded bases. They don't have stalks, attaching directly to the stem. They're arranged in whorls of three closer to the plant base, but grow opposite and smaller further up the stem. Uppermost leaves may sometimes appear alternate. Flowers occur in spiked clusters from mid-June to late September, depending on location. Flowers are 1/3 to 3/4 inch in diameter. They have 5 to 7 purple, sometimes crumpled-looking petals, with a small yellow center. Each flower produces a capsule fruit that can contain well over 100 small, light-colored seeds. A single plant may produce more than 100,000 seeds annually, sometimes up to a few million. Seeds often remain viable for more than 3 years, but potentially much longer. Stems and roots have buds that, if buried, have the ability to produce new shoots or roots. While broken sections of buried stems and roots can start new infestations if transported elsewhere, most infestation spread is by seed. Above-ground plant parts die back with autumn frosts. Dead stems persist through the winter and often decay slowly, creating a mat persistent for several years in dry environments. Plants resprout each spring from their large root systems. There are several other species of loosestrife present in North America, including both native and introduced. While many have similar pinkish-purple flowers and grow in similar habitat, the majority of these relatives are easily differentiated from purple loosestrife because they grow much shorter with much smaller or narrower leaves. Outside of this family, blue vervain, or swamp verbena, grows in a similar habitat and also has square stems and lance-shaped leaves. Blue vervain's roots are rhizombrous, its leaves have toothed margins, and its flowers are smaller and tubular at their bases. Hardhack grows in similar habitat and also has pink flower clusters. Hardhack is a shrub with round stems and alternate, toothed, oval leaves and smaller flowers with 5 petals. Other potential lookalikes grow in more terrestrial habitat and differ by having alternate leaves or a different number of petals.